Hey, what's going on, guys? Coach Clayton with Upper Class Sports back here with another video for you. In today's video, I want to go ahead and take one of my clips that I posted on TikTok that got actually a lot of views. A lot of people, some disagreed, some agreed, but I wanted to go a little bit further in depth on what I was talking about because, you know, on TikTok, you only get about a minute to explain yourself. This clip right here was 30 seconds. So I wanted to go a little bit deeper into what I was talking about when I said what I said in this clip. I'll go ahead and play the clip for you.
Pitch, come here, come back here. High pitch. Show me how you just swung at that pitch.
I literally just like went. Like...
Yeah, you went. You went from here and you went, chop! If it's a high pitch, take it back where it came from and keep going up. Up, boom, now go up with it. Up, 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 up. Yeah, stay through it. Continue up. If you're going to swing that pitch, might as well just keep going up. But the issue is once we go high pitch and we go, right? Just take it back where it came from. Keep it going up. If it's going to start up, make it go higher. Does that make sense?
So let me first start out by saying, I don't teach guys to swing at pitches out of the zone. I don't. That is not something that I do. Now, we do have drills that we do force guys to swing at every pitch no matter where it's at because we are trying to prove to them that with two strikes they can expand the zone, or if guys are not confident with hitting a pitch on the outside corner, we throw the ball even further on the outside corner to have them swing at that pitch and prove that they can get to that pitch. But in this case, that's not what we're really talking about. But he went outside of the zone and fished for a ball at his shoulders. So I wanted to tell him, look, if, key word in this clip is if
you're gonna swing at that pitch,
if you are going to swing at that pitch, which if you're a pitcher, we throw that pitch a lot because, you know, when you got a guy 0-2 or 1-2 and we're trying to use a pitch to set up another pitch, like an off-speed pitch, we use a pitch up closer towards the eyes, just above the letters or shoulder level, because that is a pitch that right by your eyes, it looks so good to the hitter. And it's hard for hitters to lay off that pitch 0-2, 1-2, and sometimes even in just regular counts because the pitch coming at the eyes, that the ball looks bigger because it's closer to your eyes. So it looks like something that is good to swing at. So he went ahead and he swung at the pitch that was just below his eyes, shoulder level, and so he chopped down on it. He went, instead of staying through the ball, he went and rolled over it. So I said, if you're going to swing at this pitch, keyword
if you're gonna swing at that pitch,
if you're going to swing at this pitch, take it back where it came from. Keep going up. Anybody who knows baseball, anybody who knows a swing, knows that the swing path goes towards the ball, and then we kind of go in the upward motion, and we finish high, usually with our hands by our left ear. 99.999% of baseball players swing a bat that way. So why on the high pitch would we want to go to the ball and then finish on a level plane? That doesn't make any sense, especially if we're going to try to drive the ball, which is something that we're always trying to do. Now, some of the comments said, yeah, but that's going to create a fly ball. Yes, of course it is, but we shouldn't be swinging at this pitch anyways. But if we are going to swing at this pitch, yes, it's going to create more of a fly ball if you don't stay through it properly. So I said, get to the ball and then take it back where it came from. If it's gonna start up, take it up and keep going higher, because we want to always finish on an upward trajectory. That helps us stay through the baseball. Now, I'm not talking about getting up underneath and trying to pop it up, but I'm talking about once we make contact, we are gonna go up with our bat. That's the way the bat naturally goes. We don't wanna get to that ball and then fade this way and then roll over it, because now we're gonna create top spin and hit a ground ball. Now, there are some instances where we need a ground ball, sure. But in this case, we are trying to hit the ball hard, hit line drives. So with this pitch, if you're gonna swing at a pitch at your shoulders, keyword, if you're going to swing at a pitch at your shoulders, let's not chop down on it and roll over it. Let's try to stay through it. And by staying through it, we are then going to be able to see a better result. So staying through that ball, we are going to have to keep going up with it, right? So if you're trying to hit a line drive in the gap, let's go the opposite way, right? If you're trying to hit a line drive in the gap and the ball is at your knees, how are you going to hit a line drive if the ball's at your knees? If we stay level through the plane of the pitch, we are going to go ahead and hit a ground ball. There's no way we're going to hit a line drive. We get to the ball and then we finish up. So now we are taking that ball up to be able to hit that line drive in the gap. Same concept applies here with the high pitch. So that's what I was thinking when I was talking to this player about swinging at that pitch. I'm not advocating or saying, hey, we need to swing at this pitch, because that pitch is not a strike. We get it. But it is a tempting pitch, and if you're a baseball player and you are a hitter, you have swung at this pitch at some point in your career. 100%, every kid has done it, and if you say you haven't been playing baseball very long, or you're just lying. So with this, I just wanted to dive a little deeper to give you guys a little bit more context on this 30-second clip, because going through some of the comments, I got ripped a little bit for this, and I also got some praise for it too, but I got ripped for this because I don't think a lot of the people watching this 30-second clip understood the context and understood why we were talking about this. They just looked at the clip itself and said, no, that's not how you swing a bat. But, you know, it is what it is. So I hope this was helpful for you and you get a better understanding of what we were talking about with this. And if you guys found this video helpful, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment down below and let me know your thoughts on this now that you have a little bit deeper, a little bit more context on it. Let me know what you guys thought. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on those bell notifications so that way you guys are notified every single time we drop a video. Thanks, guys, and we'll see you real soon.